With only 0.2% of the Philippine population having been tested for COVID-19, Senator Francis Pangilinan is also questioning the claim of Health Secretary Francisco Duque III that the country is now on its second wave of infections. Senator Pangilinan joins us today for more on this. Thank you very much, Senator Pangilinan, for taking our call. Good morning, sir.
Yes, good morning, Christian, and to your viewers. Magandang umaga sa kanilang lahat.
Okay, yesterday during the hearing of the Senate Committee of the Whole, you raised a lot of questions to address to Secretary Duque regarding the government's response to COVID-19. But first, I'd like to talk about how you reacted or saw this particular announcement coming from the Health Secretary that we're now dealing with a second wave and this possible impact on the public when it comes to how they would respond to the pandemic.
Well, you know, a second wave presupposes that there was precisely enough data, tama na yung ating siyensa, ika nga, tama na ang data, na bumaba na, nag-flatten na yung curve. Ibig sabihin ng flatten, wala nang bumababa na yung dami ng new cases. Yun ang description, yun ang definition ng flattening of the curve. Bumababa na yung new cases. Ang problema, wala naman tayong sapat na testing para masabi na talaga bang bumababa na ang new cases. Dahil nga 0.17% pa lang ang natitest. Uulitin ko, no? Gusto ko lang ibigyan din, hindi yan dapat itest yung buong population. Pero merong critical mass o critical numero na dapat matest. At dahil kulang na kulang, at sila rin ang umaamin, dapat 2%. Dapat 30,000 tests a day ang ginagawa para makita ang talagang mga pangyayari sa baba, ang dami ng mga nagkakasakit, ang dami ng gumagaling, ang dami ng asymptomatic, etc. Eh wala lahat yun eh. Kaya nga, sabi ko, nagdududa tayo na na-flatten na yung curve, number one, dahil kulang ang impormasyon. At sinasabi nila 10,000 o 11,000 tests na. Ang problema dun sa 11,000 tests, yung resulta, may backlog ng halos 6,000 hanggang 7,000 tests. Wala pang resulta. Tapos magkakaroon na ng conclusion. At hindi lamang po ito dahil sa announcement na ito. Nakita po natin sa maraming pagkakataon itong nakaraang tatlong buwan, yung mga pronouncement, kataka-taka. Noong February, sabi nga, modelo daw ang Pilipinas sa kampanya laban sa COVID. Sabi po ng DOH. Noong March, sinabi, hindi daw kailangan ng mass testing. March 20. Noong April 4, sabi ng Secretary of Health, eh, dahil kukonti lamang ang mga cases ng COVID sa Pilipinas, ito ay patunay na tama ang strategiya. Eh nasaan tayo ngayon? Tayo po ang isa sa pinakamababa ang recovery rate sa ASEAN. At tayo ang, kung hindi pinakamataas, second to the highest sa mga namamatay sa ASEAN. Hindi ibig sabihin ay maayos ang patakbo. Ang ibig sabihin, hindi maayos ang patakbo nung strategiya ng ating gobyerno.
And we're number 3 among ASEAN countries in terms of the number of confirmed cases of COVID-19.
But I'd like just to stress, no? Our fatality rate is 3 to 4 times higher than Thailand, than Taiwan. Our recovery rate, the other countries are 3 to 4 times higher than us. So talagang, and inamin naman, nung mga, kaya nga iba-iba yung sinasabi, inamin naman dun sa hearing na naghahabol tayo. At ba't tayo naghahabol? Dahil nung unang palo nung COVID, natutulog tayo sa pansitan eh. Kaya tayo naghahabol ngayon. Dahil nung pumalo na yung COVID nung Pebrero, natutulog tayo sa pansitan. Nagising tayo at naghahabol tayo ngayon. Kaya ganito ang nangyayari.
But what do you think of the timing of this announcement that we are now experiencing a second wave? At this point, you know, what do you think would be the impact?
Well, before the impact, I said, why are we patting ourselves in the back? Parang ganun ang nangyayari. May na-flatten na natin yung curve, kaya dapat second wave na ito. I don't know. Kaya nga may history of patting ourselves in the back itong DOH.
Parang diba? That was meant to make the DOH look good? to say that they were able to
able to flatten the curve. And my precisely, I said I doubt that, diba? Kasi pagka may second wave, ibig sabihin dumaan na yung first wave at na flatten. Yun ang pagkaintindi ko, ha. Kasi sinasabi nila bumaba na ang mga numero. And they have said that publicly, that they have flattened the curve. How can you do that when you don't have enough results? How can you do that when you don't test enough? Sabi ko nga, unless you do effective contact tracing sabi nila mass testing. You know, mass testing is used by all other countries. Pero kung ayaw nila lang mass testing, testing at least 2% of the population of the country. If we don't have that, we will not be able to effectively manage the spread of the disease. Mm. And until we are able to effectively manage the spread of the disease, I question the proposition or the assertion na na-flatted na yung curve.
And I think it has to be made clear, even to not just to the public, but to a lot of government officials, that when people demand mass testing, they're not saying that each and every Filipino must be tested.
You know, kalokohan yan eh. Sa buong mundo naman, hindi naman lahat ng buong Taiwan, South Korea, Singapore, they're not testing. They call it mass testing, but they're not testing the entire population. So ito eh nomenclature lang to. Parang nililihis lang yung debate. Sasabihin, hindi pwede yung mass testing. Baliwanag naman sa atin from day one, all these countries that have succeeded in managing the spread of the coronavirus use the term mass testing, and we're not talking about testing the entire population. Kalokohan yan.
Now, of course, you're not the lone person to raise the issue regarding the number of tests conducted and the slow turnaround time. But I think the argument coming from the government, from health officials, is that more or less, given the number of tests that have been conducted so far, it already gives us a picture of the scale of infection. More or less, less than 10% turn out positive and the rest turn out negative.
You know, ang problema kasi, forgive me, no? We have to err on the side of caution and be sure of the data. So if you have a backlog of 7,000 cases, wala pang resulta, and then you have itong kulang nga ang mass testing, may backlog ka na nga, kulang pa. These are two major considerations. Yan ang hirap eh. Sabi ko, we should err on the side of caution before we make public pronouncements. But what we're doing, ang ginagawa ng DOH, parang they are erring on the side of wishful thinking. Diba? Wishful thinking na we are a model in Southeast Asia. Wishful thinking na kaya mababa yung namamatay noon dahil nga tama yung strategiya. Wag ho. Let us err on the side of caution and science-based pronouncements. Hindi yung parang inuuna nating, di ba, we are patting ourselves in the back. Sabi nga eh, ginagawa pa yung exam, may grade na eh. Hindi tama yun.
Now, what about the impact or effect of this pronouncement that we are now experiencing a second wave in terms of policy making? Because, of course, government decisions need to be based on science, based on hard data, and most of them are coming from the Department of Health. But the announcement coming from the chief is that we're now in a second wave.
You know, after yesterday's hearing, kahapon, ang dami ng titek sa akin. Kasi sabi, huwag tayong maniniwala na may second wave. And these are experts, ha? Hindi ito politicians, hindi ito supporters. These are doctors, may mga PhD, saying na hindi tama. And surprisingly, if I'm not mistaken, si Executive Secretary Medialdea said hindi daw second wave yun. And even in the hearing yesterday, si Senator Bongo said ayaw niyang magkaroon ng second wave, kaya dapat habulin natin. So here we are debating now on whether there's a first wave or a second wave. But in the meantime, di ba, and in fairness naman to a number of members in the IATF, sina Secretary Charlie Galvez, for example, nagahabol. Hinahabol natin, and dapat lang. We have to ramp up. You know, South Korea has 500 testing centers. Vietnam has 112 testing centers, meaning dun sa mga expanded testing. You know, we have 30, and there are 60 still under accreditation. So talagang, we identify these countries because they're the ones that effectively addressed it. So we have to learn. matuto tayo dun sa ano, wag tayong maunang magdeklara na we flattened the curve pag ikulang pa nga yung ating ginagawa eh. Mm-hmm. Let's focus on getting, you know, getting all these test centers up. Let's focus on getting 30,000 tests a day. And then tsaka natin pag-usapan, oh, nasaan na tayo? Ano yung datos? Now, eh ngayon naghuhula-hula tayo. Sasabihin ng iba, hindi, pwede na yan. Sasabihin, hindi, kulang. Now, where gawin natin yung dapat gawin, tsaka natin pag-usapan, nasaan na tayo.
Where do you think the problem lies when it comes to the relatively small numbers still of testing laboratories? And of course, we've expanded the swab collection. No? So,
you know,
is it a matter of funding or lack of preparation?
Hindi. Maraming factors yan. Diba? May bureaucracy, may personnel. Hindi ganun kadali. Pero, you know, if the other countries have been able to do it, diba? Then we should be able to do so too. And that's precisely kaya nga natin pinasa yung Bayanihan Hilas 1 Act on March 23, 2 months ago. Because we wanted to provide this government, the administration, with the necessary tools and the necessary resources to be able to combat this COVID-19. Pero ano nangyari? Dalawang buwan. Nagde-debate pa kung dapat mag-mass test, di ba? Sa loob ng IATF. So it's a combination of several factors. But I think from day one, nung umpisa pa lang, sabi ko nga, natutulog sa pansitag. You know, I have to go back to this because very clearly, nung February 4 hearing ng Senate Health Committee, the Secretary of Health said there were 80 PUIs, persons under investigation. 80. When I asked him how many of those 80 came from Wuhan, first he didn't know the answer. He had to rely on his staff. And finally, when he got the answer, you know how many there were? 31 of
from
the
Wuhan.
80 were PUIs. We asked them, was there contact tracing? Ang sagot, nakauwi na raw, bumalik na daw sa Wuhan o bumalik na sa China. So 31 who were under investigation because they had symptoms from Wuhan did not go through contact tracing. That was February 4. Eh, ano ibig sabihin nun? Sa umpisa, kaya tayo naghahabol ngayon. Hmm. Dahil nung umpisa, nung nangyari, nung sumabog na, di ba?
And I think a number of officials also pointed this out, local officials. They're saying that we should have taken advantage of that lull between February and March and should not have been overconfident perhaps that we had already dealt properly with the first quote-unquote wave of 3 cases coming from China.
Well, kaya nga yung public pronouncement noon, modelo daw tayo sa kampanya laban sa COVID, February. Last week of February, yun ang sinabi ng DOH, we are a model in the campaign against COVID. Sabi ko, napakaaga naman itong sabihin na tayo ay modelo. Nandyan na tayo.
Okay.
We have, kaya tayo naghahabol ngayon. Uh-huh. Kaya itong mga pronouncement na ito, syempre, mag-aalala tayo. Ito ba, di ba, self-serving na naman ba itong pronouncement na ito? O ito ba, science-based?
Okay.
Ang hirap dyan, kaya nga natin in-expose yan. Because, like you said, we need to have the data to be able to approach this effectively. Ang pinaka-importante rito, may agam-agam ang ating mga kababayan. There has to be testing, tracing, and treating. Dapat ina-isolate yung mga magpa-positive tapos bibigyan ng suporta. Ganun ang approach ng ibang bansa. Kaya walang namamatay sa Singapore. Sa atin, mag-iisang libo na.
Okay.
Sa Korea, if I'm not mistaken, 200.
Mm. Finally, Senator Pangilinan, before I let you go, I'd like to move on to another important topic, very briefly lang. Of course, there was a hearing coming from the Senate regarding the franchise of ABS-CBN the other day, but you were waiting for the action from the House. But what they did was, instead of passing on second reading and third reading the provisional franchise bill, they decided to tackle the regular 25-year franchise back to the committee level. How do you think this would impact, let's say, efforts to have the network be back on air, since this is the new route that the House is taking?
Well, it's hard to tell. Again, this is a matter that House has to address. And out of parliamentary courtesy, we will just have to wait for the House action. So, hintayin natin anong magiging decision ng House of Representatives. But we have, we are ready sa Senate to tackle it. In fact, we have already had a hearing. So, hihintayin natin. We can continue to have these hearings basta wala lang committee report. So, tingnan natin, abangan natin ang ginagawa sa House.
Okay, Senator Francis Pangilinan, thank you very much for joining us this morning, sir.
Maraming salamat at stay safe, stay healthy, maghugas ng kamay, magpalakas, huwag magpuyat para malakas ang ating immunity, malakas ang ating resistensya at yan ang isa sa paraan para maligtas tayo dito sa pandemya. Okay. At siyempre, magtulungan po tayo. May mga grupo na nagtutulungan, humihingi ng mga donasyon, suportahan natin. Ang kaligtasan po natin ay nasa tulungan.
Okay, thank you very much. Senator Pangilinan. Thank you, sir.